competitors. So these are the brand connectors of M&M. Red represents Red was superior and was the leader of the pack. So Red confidently reminded why he was so special and his relationship with other brand characters. Red was undoubtedly the leader of the pack, and green, yellow represents the peanut version of the chocolate. So it represents, it shows that why he was loved by everybody. And green represents the girl power of. Represents girl power, and she was smarter, aggressive, and quicker than other male counterparts. In 1988, and the M&M brand characters proclaimed themselves as the official sport candies of the new millennium. And then movie was also made in on these brand characters. Further will be explained by Archie.
Which movie?
Colors in M&M. That's the reason this product is still in the market and it will go further for many more years.
Indian market? And how? It's in 1997.
Yes, look at initiative, sir.
Sure.
launched a campaign earlier this year by rolling out three limited edition. That was Mexican jalapeno peanut, Thai coconut peanut, and English coffee peanut. By launching these three products, people who are very interested to buy such type of product or of niche market can put their vote and select one of quality product which they like. And as per that quality, they the MMM company tried to launch that product in more quantity. And in 2018, such type of campaign has also been done by MMs, in which Crunchy Espresso and Crunchy Raspberry and Crunchy Mint Flavor. These three products has been launched by the company, and the voting has been done by the customers itself, and the product which has won is Crunchy Mint. So what this type of campaign shows that how MMM company tackle the perception of customer that MMM company is now working well in the economy or the market. So this is a short of data which shows that the brown, we can look over that in 1941 when the MMM company launched, it started with brown color, yellow color, green color, red color, and the violet one. In which we can look over that the brown color continues till 1941 to 2010, even it is also there in the market. The yellow color is also there in the market, the green one is also there in the market. But what happens with red color, it discontinued in 1976, which has been explained by my colleague Tashila Singh. In this gap, what actually happens, the perception of customer got changed in Russia. People knows that red color flavor has been used by confectionery production company which influenced to have cancer. So people's perception was by eating red color candy they may cause some cancer type of thing. So they refused to purchase that MMM candy, and at that time M&M company tackled that this type of things can tarnish the entire company, so they discontinued till 1986 to 1987. And so the return of red candies that went in your mouth but not in your hand was prompted by a national outcry that included thousands of data to the manufacturer. So this data shows that when red M&M company was introduced in the market in 1987, people were very keen to purchase that. So what the MM company has done, they introduced that red color candy packet in some sort of stores so that people get more enthusiastic to purchase that red color candy, because the complete perception of having red flavoring color that influence to have cancer was removed. So this is Miss Brown, which was always there as a queen of MM candy. And this sort of video has to be watched, which shows that the social pressure to reduce candy consumption, which actually shows what my colleague has told you all already, that how MM candy has tried to tackle the market, because in America people buy more of chocolates without caring of their health and kind of things. So for removing such type of perception, look what they have done.